Who's ready for Life is Strange Before the Storm? I played the first one, and we ended up in the first game we ended up sparing Chloe's life. Spoiler alert, sorry. If you've never played the first game, highly recommend it. There are two endings that you can get. I'm not gonna tell you what happens with both endings, but yeah. So we decided to do the good Chloe ending, as I like to call it. And this is the prequel to the first game. Concentrates on Chloe and her relationship with... I want to say her relationship with one of the main characters in the first game. One of the main non-character characters, if that makes sense. Because the person in here is very much... a part of the first game, but doesn't actually have an active part because they're not technically in the game. Commodore! Oh my goodness, Commodore 64, hello, my friend. How are you doing? It has been ages. What's going on, man? How have you been? Glad to see ya. Seriously, I'm really, really glad to see ya. I was actually wondering, thinking about you the other day. I'm like, I haven't seen Commodore in ages. I wonder how they're doing. Michael, the DLC is a short episode explaining Chloe and Max's childhood friendship. Oh, okay, that's cool. I still look forward to seeing it, though. Tom, you're doing well? I'm doing really, really fine, thank you. I mean... all things considered, you know, considering what's going on in the world and with the newest lockdown and everything connected to it. But yeah, I'm fine. Nogden, hello. Glad to see you here. How are you, Nogden? Did you have a good weekend? Commodore, yeah, exactly. 2020, fine, yeah. And Rock, welcome in. Guess what? What happened? What's going on? Nogden, you're pretty good, thanks. You had a good weekend. Oh, glad to hear it. I mean, yeah. I played games all weekend, so typical but good weekend for me as well. Rock, as long as the stream doesn't buffer, you can be in here because you got your earbuds. Nice. Hooray for earbuds. Ah, same here, Nogden. I've been looking forward to playing the Life is Strange series since we played the first game. So the idea is to play all of the Life is Strange series. So we're going to play Before the Storm... Life is Strange 2, The Wonderful Adventures of Captain Underpants, and so on. Rock? Oh no, I'm so sorry, Rock. Sorry that the stream is buffering for you. It's okay here. I'm guessing it's your... Are you on mobile internet? If so, that totally sucks. Nogden? No, I haven't. Haven't played this one at all, no. Played the first one, but not this one. So it's a total blind playthrough here, except for what I know about the characters from the first game. So let's go ahead and we'll delve in. So we've got episodes 1, 2, 3 and the bonus episode. Okay, so, Michael, you've played this game before, haven't you? Would you recommend playing... Yeah, there's the bonus episode. Would you recommend that I play the bonus episode first, or start from the beginning? Because I know the bonus episode takes place before these three episodes do. The bonus, Nogden, the bonus episode is first in the story. Okay, cool. Michael, I'll want to play the Amazing Adventures of Captain Spirit before, well, I don't know why I said Captain Underpants. I'm thinking the TV cartoon there. So I'll want to play Captain Spirit before Life is Strange 2. Okay, no worries. I think I've got it in the panels in the correct playing order, so... Nogden, you played all of them apart from Life is Strange 2. I will get to it, I promise. Okay, so let's play the bonus episode first then, since this takes place before the actual game. Rock, you'll rewatch parts you missed later. Okay, no worries. Oh my god, is that a... It is. Barbie dolls. Wait. Wait a minute. Why are they...
I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max.
Even when science means blowing shit up.
Oh no. Oh no. This is not gonna end well, is it? Oops.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
Yeah, okay, that was totally amazing.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
Cue the mother?
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Oh, dear. I have to admit... I did own Barbie dolls when I was a kid. I never exploded them with fireworks, though.
Probably because I have. I can't...
Nogden, you played this after the main game too. Ah, okay. But we'll see how well it goes. We'll see how well it meshes.
In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Michael, this is Chloe we're talking about. It's her style. Totally, yes. And Commodore, Set and you are Aw, congrats, Com. And Set. That is awesome. Congrats to you both.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
So Chloe was a straight A student. Wow. All right, let's start from the hoodie and work our way all the way back around to Chloe.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
Safe.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine. It's filled with holes and falling apart.
It is a bit ratty.
It never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
While the ads are going, I'll just take a brief break for a drink. So the more I eat of these Greek patos rolls, the sweeter they're getting. It's supposed to be hot pepper flavor, but they're getting sweeter the more I eat them instead of spicy. Mad. Nogden, this bonus episode and the main game answers a lot of questions. Cool.
Belongs in the trash box.
All right, let's see what's in the drawer. Is that one of those everlasting gobstoppers?
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
If that's an everlasting gobstopper, that needs to go in the trash because it's probably rank by now if it was bought years ago. Ugh.
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Oh god, okay. I'm gonna let you guys answer this. Should we lick it? Or toss it. Oh, Nogden, lick it. You may get superpowers. All right.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending...
Oh, and they both licked it. Oh, gross.
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Growth spurt can come any day now. Oh, dear. The sucky boys.
I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
Mr. Sharky. I can't remember if she had Mr. Sharky in the first episode. What about the trash?
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't touched this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum. That's better.
I'm just gonna try to throw everything in the trash just to see what she says.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Ooh. She got in, because she got into that exclusive school, didn't she? Acceptance letter.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
To the parents of Chloe Price. Dear parents, congratulations! Sounds like they just won the lottery. Your child, Chloe Price, has been accepted for September 2008 admission to Blackwell Academy. I don't know why I'm reading it in this voice. We have offered places to approximately 100 students out of 1,200 applicants. Your child excelled in all criteria for admission. An open house for admitted students and parents will be held on March 26th. April 2nd is the deadline to inform us of your intentions regarding admission. Your admission reply form is included. For those who require financial aid, please contact Blackwell's Office of Financial Assistance. We look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Blackwell Academy family. Sincerely, Marco Escanzolas, Director of Admissions. Nogden, you love the voice actor for Chloe. Fantastic voice actor, I agree.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
So many Petri dishes. Students,
are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
I'm not sure I believe her.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks, I guess.
Normal, huh?
I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Aw. Alright, so what is this? Ooh!
Hey.
Camera.
What's your dad's camera doing?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes.
Oh, this was before that incident.
You're off to a great start.
And thus, her love of selfies was born.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
Michael, you know they changed the voice actor for Chloe from the first game. There was a voice acting union strike while they recorded Before the Storm, so they had to find another actor. I mean, they do sound a little bit different from what I remember, but enough, it's similar enough that if you didn't know, you wouldn't be able to tell. Which just goes to show you how good of a voice actor they managed to find.
Chloe no longer cares about? That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into
it's still
a
smoking.
Technical adventure?
Alright, so let's open the drawer. Find out what's inside. Miss Madeline's Menagerie of Magic.
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
Trash?
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection.
In one box.
How many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
Saw me in half.
Now that's next.
How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Okay, fine.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
Alright.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still
got... Oh yeah, we already did that. Before we talk to Chloe, we'll lie down on the bed. But at the moment, I want to finish, you know, looking around. Glowy Bear!
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you. Oh, almighty Glowy Bear.
What? Board game? Oopsies?
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
Trash? Uh-oh, she's gonna say something.
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Wait, you beat me?
That's BS. The last time we played, I wiped the floor with you.
Poor Max. Losing your memory at such a young age.
She's as bad as I used to be about deciding what to throw away and what not to.
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out.
Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear.
Any new moves?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right. Back to the junk mines.
Oh, dear. Oh, my God. I think I had a poster that looked like that back when I was a kid.
I should check in with
Chloe. No, I'm not finished looking.
I always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Oh, besides Bongo, of course.
I totally had a poster that looked almost exactly like that when I was a kid. I swear.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Oops. Comic strip?
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
The Mysterious Adventures of Supermax and Dr. Kloenstein. Our crime fighting has really soared since she created these rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Kloenstein? Oh no! Oh no! Dr. Kloenstein's disappeared. Let's have a look, see what there is.
Talk about embarrassing.
Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all ma-
Sharpie boob jobs.
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Funny. I have to admit, I never did anything like that when I was a kid. But then this is Chloe we're talking about.
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures. Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies.
Well, I did that a lot when I was a kid. Oh, wow. Okay, that is so cool. The mirror. In programming, there's loads of different ways that you can do a mirror like that. One is by having, like, the game kind of run in two different places. So once here, and then once, like, behind the mirror. And it looks like that's probably what they've done there. However they did it, it's a really cool effect. All right, let's lie on the bed, since we haven't done that yet. Leave no stone unturned with this game, I have learned.
It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town, all in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things. Pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Aww. I love the music in this game as well. The music in the first one was awesome. I think this one they managed to get the license to an indie artist as well, which is super, super cool. Nogden, you always think the mirror effects in games are so awesome. Yeah, they definitely are. And they really did a fantastic job in this one. In some games, the mirror effects aren't fantastic. This one is so awesome. Ooh. Smilebringer, hello, how are you doing? Subscribing for 19 months in a row. Thank you. I appreciate you being here, Smilebringer. How are you? Did you have a good weekend? How's your new job? Tell me. I want all the deets. But while you're typing that, let me
tried my best
stamp your heart.
I should check in with Chloe now.
If I can find your heart. Oop. Oop. There you are. There we go. The first stamp didn't take. I had to restamp. Smilebringer, you're doing good, thanks. Stamp, not stab. No. I would never stab your heart. That hurts. Whereas stamping on it, it does not, you know.
Best to clean this place. I should check in with Chloe now.
I'm glad you're all right, Smilebringer. Definitely glad you're okay. Michael, the soundtrack in Life is Strange 2 is good as well. Got some very good music in it. I mean, I'm really, really looking forward to playing all of the games just to listen to the music, to be honest. Don't care about the storyline. Just the music. I kid. Nogden, you love it when games pay attention to details like that. Definitely. Smilebringer, depends on if it's Cupido that stabs you, suppose. I mean... However, I am not Cupid, so.
If you want more trash, you'll have to find it. Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two under-supervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Uh-oh, what's gonna happen? All right. Should we... I'll let you guys choose again. Should we tell her now that she's gonna be leaving or tell her later? Personally, I would say, you know, tell her now, but I can understand the tell her later bit. While you decide for me... I'll catch up with chat. Nogden, am I going to play Tell Me Why as... yes. I don't think I own the game yet, but I'm definitely going to get it. And we will definitely play it. Smilebringer, the job is going really, really well so far. Ooh, two relays. There's so much to learn. So it's first a lot of learning stuff before the work stuff happens. Oh, I'm so happy for you though, Smilebringer. I really hope that it goes well for you. After so long searching for a job, you really, really deserve this. Michael, you're staying out of this. You've completed it. Rock, yes, this is a bonus episode. It's the bonus episode that comes, yeah, as Nogden says, it comes before the actual Before the Storm. So we're playing it first. Smilebringer, you're glad to have it. Just got to make sure to keep it now, though. I'm sure you will. You'll be fine. Just apply your hard work ethic to everything that you do, as you do, and yeah, you'll be absolutely fine. I think we're gonna tell her now, and we'll probably get interrupted, so we won't be able to. But we're gonna try it.
Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. Shit. Max, hold that thought. Must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Irate related.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago.
It's well, obviously. The date's on there.
To our current selves.
Oh, no.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer!
Oh, cringe.
You are such dwarf.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
mine eyes spot two fair pirate wenches.
What a... Dad, get away! We're
the project. Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame.
Oh, dear.
If it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again.
Hey Shiraya, how's it going? You haven't missed much, and Rocky, you haven't missed much either. You missed us tidying the room, or trying to tidy up Chloe's room. It didn't work. Dorky. That was totally dorky. Oh my god. How you doing, Shiraya? Have you had a good weekend? So I'm just laughing at that. Michael, you were interested in getting tell me why, but it's only on Xbox and PC. You don't have an Xbox or a PC powerful enough to play it. Ooh. One day, Michael, one day you will. And then you can play it. And then you can gush over how awesome it is, because it is an awesome game, from what I've seen. Alright, so yeah, that was totally dorky.
So dorky.
I've got an itchy nose. Ooh.
I thought we were lovable. Okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting.
Oh, no.
I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Oh, here we go. Shirai, you've had a great weekend. You really needed the sleep. Oh, so you slept all weekend, huh? We slept in a little bit on Sunday, but Saturday we got up at pretty much our normal time. It's weird. The older I get, it's like, no matter what time I go to bed at night, I always wake up at the same time. And when I was younger, and like regularly, you know, like in high school, lived with my mom, I regularly slept through my alarms. And I'm like, with my mom, I'm like, how do you get up at 6 a.m. every single morning, 7 days a week, whether you have to work or not? And she's like, it's just become a habit. And I'm like, that will never become habit with me. And guess what? It's become habit to get up at the same time every morning, whether I've got things planned for that day or not. Once again, my mother, the prophet, was correct. Shariah, not at all. You did the Halloween board game night. Ooh, nice. How did that go? I hope it went really, really well. And what did you dress up as? All right, property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. The Bane of Arcadia. Crow's Nest Saloon, Cockpit, Galley, Treasure Keep, Cannons, Plank. Most important bit of any pirate ship is the plank. Rock, where did you get 6,000 parsecs? That's from the, the points challenge. You know, the watch a scary film. We didn't make the donation amount. So I could only, it gave me the option of either extending it or refunding everyone's points. So I refunded everyone's points. Which reminds me, thank you, Rock. We have a few more community challenges down below, everyone, that you can exchange your parsecs towards. We've got Wear a Onesie Night, where if we meet that goal, I will wear a onesie of your choosing. I will actually buy a onesie that you guys choose for me, and I will wear it during the stream. A Christmas film night during the month of December. And a YouTube tutorial series, a short one, like 6 videos, on how different things that you can do as a Twitch how to do different things on Twitch as a viewer, geared towards, you know, like, do you have an auntie who says, I would love watching you, if you stream, I would love watch you on Twitch, but I don't know how to make an account. Well, you know, I can, if that one gets chosen and we reach that one, then I will do videos on how to make an account, how to link up your Amazon Prime with Twitch account, and other things. So. So yeah, 3 to choose from. I put them all down. One is like 10k, one's 15k, and one's 20k. So hopefully one of you guys will do it. Shariah's contributed 2,000 to the onesie stream. Thank you, Shariah. I appreciate that. Shariah, sadly you didn't have time to pick up your costume. Oh no. Neither did the rest of the party. Too much work. But I'm glad you had fun, though. You whooped a lot of cultist butt as the kid in Cthulhu. glad to hear it, Shariah. I mean, you know, you gotta whoop cultist butt. It's the only way to do it. Rock, this game is big pogger, definitely. Okay, so let's see what else is here. Let's see. Next. Photos, Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. Oh, dear. Pogo the Pirate and the gang. I'm surprised they managed to get the cat dressed up in a costume like that, because I mean, Felix won't even let me, she won't even let me put her put on a new collar, let alone dress her up like that. Not a chance. Ha Pirate rules. No bathing. No boys on the ship. No sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder. Always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Arrrr. Ruck, by the way, for like an hour, the ASDF movie 1 to 13 complete collection was up, but he took it down because there was an issue. What issue? Hello, voice actor. How are you doing? You all right? Cheerio. Pip pip. Hey, what? Ogden, never give up, never surrender. Oh, dear. Rock, the credits were wrong. Oh, okay, that explains things. And we've got yet another ad, so I'm gonna have some crisps while the ad goes. Bye-bye. Oh. Chip, chip, doodle, pip. Yes, exactly. I'm glad you agree. Rock, the ASDF movie 4 said movie 5, and movie 10 said movie 3. Oh, okay, that's weird. Easy to do, I guess. Captain's log. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just-buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil Commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it, because our enemies want our treasure so bad. We must make sure the map is only readable to us, Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. More plunder and riches, Captain Bluebeard, Long Max Silver.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Uh-oh. Ruck, you're typing ADSF movie a lot.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map? If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
Hmm.
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. But where could it be?
Where would it be? Let's see, there's a drawing there.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder.
Voice actor, this is the bonus episode, yes.
School supplies from that year.
Ruck, is the bonus episode just Max right before she moved? Yeah, I believe it is, yeah. I think it's also before Chloe's dad died, because she mentioned that her dad gave her the camera so that Max could use it on this day. So it sounds like Chloe's dad might also be alive. Chloe Price, 2003, 100%. Great job as always, Chloe. Now please try to pay attention in class instead of drawing pictures with Maxine. Okay, so let's see.
I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together.
United States Social Studies. Oof. I had that, I remember U.S. social studies when I was a kid. Hello, what's this? There we go. Chloe's secret lair. Dark cavern. Amulet. Treasure Island. Price Castle. Okay.
I'm remembering this now.
didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Still scary?
Was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
I mean
the swings?
The pirate ship. Captain.
Yes, the pirate ship.
Right again, bitches!
I'll find.
Oh dear.
Tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Rock, do I know how long the bonus episode is? Not a clue. Okay.
Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
Okay, so let's nose around the entire house first.
Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it.
Nogden, it's only about an hour. Are you sure about that? I mean, this is me you're talking about.
Things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
Rock, will I get to episode one?
Chloe's mom.
No one knows.
Because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate.
Voice actor, about 2 hours at most, knowing me. I mean, yeah. Hello, what's this?
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. I can't believe I won't be able to call.
Just in case, you know, I mean, there might be an achievement for look at all the things.
I've never actually seen anyone reading these books.
Rock, lol, probably.
Awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it.
The College of Arcadia's Early Childhood Education Certification Program. If this is what you want, we'll find a way to make it work. W.
Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise.
Ooh.
So cool.
From Portland, Oregon to Phoenix, Arizona.
I'm such a nature nerd.
The Grand Canyon. I don't think they ever got to go, though.
Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little.
Should we look at it?
I asked her about school earlier.
Rock. Nosy ass, look at everything possible and take all pictures. I mean, yeah. Voice actor, I wouldn't like to trophy hunt the Stanley Parable. No, I tried that. No. I love the game, but no.
Chloe's parents. I wonder what about.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Price. I would like to begin by saying we are thrilled to have Chloe at Blackwell. Rest assured, her scholarship is not in jeopardy. At this time, however, it seems she's having trouble transitioning into this new, more challenging environment. I'm emailing to set up a time to talk about the incident that occurred last week. I'm very concerned about Chloe's behavior and would like to work with you to take steps to correct it as soon as possible. I'm sure you are as dedicated to Chloe's success here as we are. The future needs excellence! Regards, Ray Wells.
Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her.
Ray, Chloe was not the only student to act out that day, and if you ask me, Marissa Rogers isn't the victim. Cheese, the bully. Maybe if both sides of the story were heard before placing blame, your school would be a less challenging environment for your students. Focus on your school. I'll focus on my daughter, William Price.
A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there.
Boy, Max was nosy, even back then. To Joyce Price, these types of people are exactly why I didn't want Chloe at Blackwell. We'll figure this out, I promise. I love you too. From Joyce Price, I forgot to tell you, Mrs. Rogers called while we were out yesterday and left a message. It's still on the answering machine, but please be careful when you listen to it. I don't want Chloe to overhear. We need to figure out how to handle this. I know the principal said her scholarship isn't in danger, but I still worry. Love you.
Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
To Aaron Price, from William Price. Thanks for the pressure washer. Finally used your pressure washer today, and I just wanted to say thanks again for letting me borrow it. It works like a charm. It's not our dream house, but now it can at least be the right color. If you want to come over next weekend and give me a hand, there'll be a cold beer in it for you. Give me a call. Hope everything at work is still going well, and tell Linda I say hello. William. Voice actor, one is called Go Outside, Don't Play the Game for 5 years. I've heard about that one, yeah. Rock, Max is not nosy when you play the game. You look at nothing. Not because you don't want to look at anything, you just forget. I mean, yeah, legit.
Trying to quit smoking.
Totally legit.
Oh, Chloe's parents are so cute.
San Francisco holidays with William and Chloe.
Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles.
Waffles.
No other diner could even come close.
Ooh.
It's so sweet that Chloe's mom
took
this photo with her to work.
Aw. Rog, meanwhile, Miramax makes Max extremely nosy. I mean, yeah. foreshadowing. Tollbridge and Oliver Sharp mystery. You'll pay with your life.
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
Rock, didn't I find someone's pregnancy test or something in the main game? Yeah, I definitely did.
Slipped and broke this post a few years ago, but Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
All right, so can we go downstairs?
We gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe.
No, we can't. Okay. So enough procrastinating. Let's go.
Into
the dark cavern.
Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet.
Also, I love her shirt. Just saying.
There it is.
It's so cute.
Dark cavern.
The dark cavern.
I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
Rock, Max returns the favor if you take blame for the weed. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I believe we did in my playthrough.
Maybe this will make me tall enough to reach.
Really, that thing is so freaking. That's not strong. You're so gonna fall through that. I don't believe I'm doing this. She is so gonna fall through that. Or end up breaking her neck. I've tried to use those as steps ladders before. They don't work.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
Oh, this isn't gonna end well, is it? Okay, what? Toolbox?
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project.
No. What can I use? Towel? No. Maybe something in Chloe's room?
Chloe's room has always been home base.
No.
It's hard to think this might be the last.
Ooh, hello. There's a stepladder there.
For me to reach, but maybe I can stack things on top of it.
All right, let's stack. I mean, you know, she could just go downstairs and ask for an adult's help.
Almost there. I just need a few more inches.
I mean, you know, just...
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around that.
Just saying. You know, asking for an adult's help is totally, totally the best way to do things here. Chloe, or Max, sorry, wrong person. Books?
If I stack a bunch of books on the stool, I could probably reach the attic.
Go ahead, Rock goes downstairs. Hey, William, can you help me? It's that easy. I mean, I know, right? Instead, she's gonna nearly break her neck trying to get up into the attic by stacking everything.
I think that should be tall enough.
Voice actor chooses guide of the raid. The nerdy Kraken has come out of his cave since about 6 months. Lol. No worries, voice actor. We can totally do that. Let me find a pen to write that username down. Otherwise, I will forget. So, the Nerdy Kraken. That is such an awesome name, by the way. A-R-A-K-E-N. There we go. I've got it written down. We will totally do that. Oh boy.
Should be stable enough. Besides,
what's a little adventure without a lot of risk to your neck? Oh jeez, I don't want to look. I can totally see it. I've got like three versions of the game here. I'm not even kidding. Oh god, spiders. Oh, they had to show that, didn't they? I'm not scared of spiders, honest. They just creep me out sometimes. She could have brought a flashlight. Oh, there's a light up there. Okay. You know, that's better.
Stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is.
Oh, of course. The amulet's just, you know.
We hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through.
Right. Okay.
No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing.
The retail. But there's four of them. Alright, so I need to get to the amulet. Alright. Creep. An old TV.
It took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
Rock, Max is so not noisy when you nosy when you play, because in the main game it took you 2 attempts to save Kate, which you're not happy about. If Chloe got back there, you can too, Max. Stop the BS.
Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality.
Aw, Chloe's old crib. An old chair.
With this chair here.
Then push it, dear Liza.
I think I can squeeze through now.
Bum-ba-dum-bum-bum-bum-ba-da-da-dum. Ah, push it. Push the chair. Sorry. Thank you, Smilebringer. I'm glad you're singing along there. Press left mouse button to squeeze through. Right. Smile, but you're not sure if that's channel appropriate. It's a song about it's a song about dancing in a club. Yes. That's totally what that song is about. Totally. Rock Max doesn't know common sense confirmed. I mean, yeah. Smilebringer, talk yourself out of that one. Oh, I can talk myself into and out of so many things.
I bet I can find a way through, though.
I'm sure you can, Max. I'm sure you can.
Single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Possible. Fish tank!
I remember this.
Hey, wait a minute. Where are the fish?
Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack.
Oh, no. A watery grave. Our Christmas box.
That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5.
That Smilebringer, mainly into, I mean, yeah.
But I think they're cute.
I'm able to talk myself into the most uncomfortable of situations and the most amazing things, such as chocolate cake and hot chocolate and horror games. Yeah, I can talk myself into all sorts of things.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly.
Big and burly?
This furniture would be kind of difficult.
Uh-huh. Before we move the furniture, is there anything else? Okay, so we can push things, we can pull things. I think it's over there that we need to get to, so... If we... Oh, hello, there's a cooler there.
I need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way.
Okay. So if we pull the desk...
Keep it moving, desk.
Ow.
Crap.
Push?
Guess you have to go back.
Alright, there's gotta be a way of doing this. Alright, so let's see. We've got the desk, we've got the cooler, we've got the dresser, so...
I need to move that desk, but this dresser is...
Alright, so we move the dresser. Then we move the desk. And then we move the cooler.
One step closer.
And of course, the parents, or a parent at least, is in this house. And with all of this crashing around in the attic, no one comes up to check. You know, I mean...
This thing is empty.
I would totally be wondering what the heck the kids were doing up there if it was up to me. Shariah, sleepy time. Have a good night, Shariah. Sleep well. Thank you for dropping in. I appreciate it.
Yes.
And I hope you have a good week. Left mouse button to squeeze through. If that isn't a meme, just begging to be memed, I don't know what is.
Finally.
It's like, press F to pay respects. In this case, it's press left mouse button to squeeze through. Let's take a look at it.
Reward for a journey full of
Rock, what? Every time Max needs to squeeze through something, a message appears at the bottom of my screen saying, left button to squeeze through.
This is a nice close-up shot.
And I said, that's definitely a meme begging to be memed.
Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
It looks like a jar lid. Press P to pog. We're not gonna climb out the window, are we? Please tell me we're not gonna climb out of the attic window.
Chloe Price.
Oh no. We're just
it's so weird being back.
Talking to ourselves again. Okay. It's fine.
I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
That is why I don't like basements or attics.
Man.
Don't like the idea of spiders falling on top of my head. Really, really don't. Wonder if I can take a photo.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
Share your feelings or act natural. Rocks, press space to leave. I bet she'll jump out the window. Let's see. Should we share our feelings or should we act natural? Let's act natural.
I'm just getting some light. This cavern is even darker than I remember.
Did you conquer your fears?
You could say that.
Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
No. You can't make me. I won't do it. I refuse to play your games. Oh, wait. Never mind. Okay.
Dude, you did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes...
I like how the swing set or pirate ship has a cannon on it. I mean, that's just hilarious. Alright, let's go over and give this to Chloe, by which I mean, let's look at everything in the back garden.
The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
Yes.
I wish this was big enough to jump in.
Then pick up a rake.
It'll be totally dive-bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah, a few weeks.
You don't have a few weeks. Sorry, Chloe. Hate to bust your grill.
I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues.
You see what I did there? I said, hate to bust your grill, and then I walked over to the barbecue grill. Yeah?
All I'm
saying
is...
See what I did?
Never
mind.
Taking a picture.
Hello? Can I come in? Hello? Okay.
I can't wait to see what we're supposed to do with the amulet. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting
oh, dear.
A lot more fun than taking it off.
Yeah, I can believe that. Ouch. Tire garden.
This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow.
Honestly, growing plants isn't that difficult. All you need is some rich dirt, a thing to put the dirt in, and a packet of seeds, and remember to water it every so often. Right, quite easy. Rocks, Max, why is Mir making you so damn nosy? Chloe, you can't break the fourth wall like that.
Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now.
Oh, it's the mural.
I still wish I could live in the world we drew.
Are we gonna end up hitting someone or breaking the window?
So much of my
Break the
life here.
window, break the window, break the window, break the window, break the window. I mean, what?
Comforting. These games we're playing, buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going
Sup, dude?
to?
Bro. Don't you mean sis?
Okay, I'm gonna let you guys choose. Should we call Chloe a nerd or a dweeb? Let's play Choose Your Insult. Simply type A for nerd or D for dweeb. Rock votes A. We have one vote for A. Sup? Like the fawns. A. On that note, I'm pouring myself the rest of this beer. Do we have any advances on A? A going once. A going twice. It's the font. I mean, rock your world with nerd.
Maybe I meant nerd. Door.
Oh, geez. Punk or doofus? Rock, Max, laughing my ass off. Nerd. Doofus. I like the word doofus. I just gotta go with doofus. Always go with doofus.
Good talk.
Good talk. I like it. Toy soldiers.
Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it. Oh, I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Ha
Rare is
Lol.
never appreciated.
How I lost my magnifying glass privileges. I love it.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Do you drink this? Yar.
Oh, well, what's this?
Hello?
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
Heh.
That's probably for the best. Some pirate you are.
I was eating those beans. I was eating those beans. Right, let's take a photo.
If we ever want to. Hey, Chloe.
I don't care about the photo or about the treasure. Ooh, all right. Walk the plank or land ho. Let's do land ho. I mean, we don't want Captain Bluebeard to walk the plank. That's just silly.
Land ho!
There we go. Ooh, we have a tab. Bring Chloe the amulet. Oh, look. It's the map with a note from Chloe and Max. Bring Chloe the amulet. And the photos that we've taken. I like it. And then we've got the collection, which is Chloe's secret lair, which is all the stuff that we found. Stuff that we found in the dark cavern. Ah, oh, I love the way they did this. So, because we don't have a mobile phone, it's the map instead of the mobile phone. Oh, I like it. That is awesome. That is super awesome. Okay. Anyway, let's finish up here. Ooh, pardon me, hiccups.
This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it. Actually, after this morning...
I was about to say... Glider swing. Oh, I used to have a swing set that had a glider swing.
Simulate a storm on the high seas.
I didn't call it a glider swing, though. I called it a seesaw swing. But it was my favorite swing. There was another swing that we had on my swing set when I was a really little kid. It was like two bench seats, and you could get two little kids on each seat. And they were facing each other. And there was a floor to it. So it was like two bench seats like this with a floor right underneath. So you could have two little kids on each bench, on each seat, and you could have like one or two kids on the floor, you know, standing up, and you had to use your feet to be able to swing back and forth, push on against the floor and lean back, and time it just right and work with each other to get it to swing. It was one of my favorite swings on our swing set. I loved it. Ooh, beep. Smile bringer, seesaw, yes.
Freeze this moment. I never have to.
So I think that's a little bit of a bug with the game. That it interrupts, it ends the dialogue before it actually ends.
We're supposed to do with the...
Alright, let's give her the amulet.
Yar! You must ask permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
And I'm the dork? Now let's play around along. Permission to come aboard.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
She's good.
Right up. Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this... Stay on. Stay here. I think I saw some tape. Thanks, Max.
Oh, dear.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure.
Smilebringer, seesaws would not have sawed a source... Oh, God. The tongue twister. Why, Smilebringer? Okay. Seesaws would not have sawed a sword seesaw, so seesaw sawed swords seesaw. But it was sad to see sore just because seesaw sawed swords seesaw. There you go. It's like, Peter Pepper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Pepper picked. If Peter Pepper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Pepper picked?
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure, whatever it is.
We have the tape. Let us... Ooh, a flag.
I never understood why it's called a jolly...
I didn't look at the flag. Gotta look at the flag.
How jolly can you be if you're dead?
Very, very jolly.
If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Why not, Rock? Why not?
Loser.
You have to grasp life with your bare hands and choke it until it gives in. I mean, what? Totally did not check with D.
Chloe.
There we go.
You could never be a loser. Even if you tried.
Oh, yeah. The best friend code requires you say that.
Best friend code.
It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
Arrrr. All right, have the tape.
Have you brought me prize?
Pirate's tape. We might as well get into character, am I right?
I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Come, Max.
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were going to be pirates forever.
We're still pirates.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates. Hell yeah.
Thank you, Smilebringer. Drop it on Discord. Ah, oh, cheers. Thank you.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Oh, here we go. And we find the treasure.
How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something.
Here goes nothing.
It's upside down.
This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Okay. Ooh! Rock! By the way, it is the beginning of the month, Rock. Do you want to do the honors to make the clip of the month? Or The chat command for the clip of the month. That's the one. All right. AD to spin the lens. And move the... We did it! We did it!
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Right.
Okay, take a step right.
No, my right.
No, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
Mine?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
Funny. Smilebringer. Power Clipper of the Month is a hard title to get, by the way. Hey, Kazzy, how's it going? Oh yeah, we're playing pirates at the moment, Kazzy. Digging for buried treasure. Arrrr. Oh god, that one got clip of the month? Seriously?
Not what we buried.
Exclamation mark chain? It's what I say the most in that clip. What did we find? I got distracted by Twitch clips. Whatever it was, that is not what we buried.
I don't know. Let's open it.
It's a head, isn't it? Oh, no, it's not a head.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
Oh, get the tape player!
Bloody Bill?
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ah, so it's a treasure from Chloe's dad, is it? Okay.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Buddy Bill the Pirate.
Oh no.
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary. I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you.
Aww.
Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed, and always remember... the real treasure is...
friendship. Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid...
Oh, dear. And thanks for doing that, that command there, Rock. I appreciate it.
Originally buried. Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Billy the Squid.
It really is like a time capsule. No way! Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters. Oh, I remember these.
Oh dear.
To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute.
Yeah.
Check it out. Ugh, Maxine.
Dear Chloe, how are you today? I am doing very well. It is Friday, June 27th, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it pirate-themed. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal. Arabian horse, Max. Otter, Chloe. Favorite food, lobster roll, Max. Coffee ice cream, Chloe. I'll agree with Chloe on both of those things. Favorite class in school, art or library, Max. Science, Chloe. Library is not a class. Sorry, Max. Although it was my favorite thing when I was a kid in school as well. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Sincerely, Maxine Caulfield. Oh dear. That is so cringe.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? 1. We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh. 2. We have sleepovers at least once a week. 3. We like extremely salty pretzels. 4. We are in a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. 5. We're going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. 6. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guessed all of them, you are right. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price. Rock, she should have said recess. That's not a class either. Recess isn't technically a class, but it would be a funny joke. I mean, true. You were really funny. You were really sweet. Funny. Sweet? Funny.
You were really funny. Mine was
Rock or lunch. Oh god, no.
Yeah, that's you. Serious and genuine.
Sorry. But I mean, any kid who says that lunch is their favorite part of school, they must have one heck of a good lunch menu.
I thought they'd be home by now.
My lunch menu when I was their age, or when they wrote that letter, like 8 years old, was always like, what is this? I have no idea. And Is this still alive?
All these memories. I want to look at everything.
Okay. You heard her. She said it. She wants to look at everything. So we'll start from the door.
Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore. These used to make great pirate swords.
Rock, your school lunch is kinda okay sometimes. Mirror, why? Because Max said she wanted to look at everything. So I'm just fulfilling Max's wish.
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho. I guess compared to that, Seattle's not so far.
And there's something that... Hold on, gotta fix that. There we go. Is that better? Yes, okay. Sorry, my keyboard was uneven. I hate that. So annoying.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's...
It's still uneven. Why are you uneven?
Oh. Chloe to hear
that would do it.
But
there we go.
If Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell, this might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
Ooh, do we listen? Do we? Let's save that. Rock, sorry, you just can't wait for me to play episode one. We will get there. We will get there. I promise.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Oh, it's the photo that we took and the history or the weird time travel-y thing. Rock, God, I know, right?
This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner.
Let's tidy up. One hour later.
Much better.
Somebody's a goody two-shoes.
Someone's a goody two-shoes.
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
Aw. Me and Daddy. Cute.
Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me.
Manga magazine, get down.
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house.
Rock, you don't want to think about that effed up alternative reality. I know, just so sad.
This container looks like it could last 100 years. Lupin, we used to read every issue from cover to cover.
Lupin Magazine. Stories for children from around the world. Oh no. Deja vu.
There. Now you've got something pretty to look at.
Deja vu!
Hey, little guy. Aren't you cold in there?
Rock, remember when I was playing Life is Strange and someone redeemed me to name something? Yeah, that was, I mean, I can't, yeah.
Of course, so much fun in third grade.
So weird.
You sure were troublesome to find.
A book.
That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
Stories about women changing careers in mid-life.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it.
A video game.
Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Oh. I mean, you know, that would be pretty cool, but yeah.
Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance.
Wow, Chloe's allowance. Save 60%, spend 40%. Wow, I was never that good when I was a kid. I am like horrible at saving money. Rock, posture check, and stretch. We'll do the stretch first, then the posture check, because it just makes sense doing it in that order. So stretch, this is where you guys get involved. The stretch isn't just for me, it's for you, because if you've been watching me stream for nearly 2 hours, you also need to stretch. So everyone, back straight, this is a chair stretch. Arms up over your head. Stretch to the left. Stretch to the right. Stretch backwards until your shoulders touch the back of your chair. And roll your shoulders a bit. Roll your head, your neck around. You should, if you're like me, you should hear a satisfying crunch in the back of your neck. That's how you know you did the stretch correctly. And posture check. The back of the bum should be in the back of the chair. The chair should be as close to the desk as possible. And shoulders back, head up, chest out. And there we go. Let's open the book.
I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
You want to bounce on the sofa, do you? Okay. Ooh, there's photo. Actually, couch. Can I? Ah.
This used to be the rainy day pirate ship.
Cassie, this was just right. What the stretch?
Chloe and I have been.
I know how to stretch. I am good at stretching.
Worrying too much about this move changing.
Oh my god, they were an ice cream cookie sandwich. Ah, I love it. That's too cute. Cassie, yep, master. Halloween 2002. Is he what is he supposed to be? A loaf of bread? And then, wait, is that a ghost? Who is the what? That's weird.
A time capsule was such a good idea.
I know, right? We're geniuses.
Rock, Christmas, since you know, it's November. Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Rock. Oh, Christmas tree. How many are your branches? Spicy chicken ramen, hello, how are you? It looks like he was dressed as a clothes wardrobe. Ah, that's possible. Glad to see a spicy chicken. I love the name, by the way. Absolutely love the name. All right, we're going to listen. We probably shouldn't, but we're going to. Uh-oh.
Hey, hold on. Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Oops.
Shit.
What happened?
Cromer Gaming! Hello, welcome, my friend. How are ya?
I was exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
They both sound awful.
They both sound awful. Marissa and her mom.
They are. All Marissa talks about is, like, how much she hates her tutor, but she never does any homework.
Marissa.
I told you, I hate fake people.
Marissa.
Is everybody there like that?
Wait.
No, not everyone. But more than I'm used to. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner incense. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe. What do you mean she
was... Well, what's this?
She was making fun of my clothes and... calling me a scholarship kid.
Is that why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
Marissa. Isn't Marissa the one that we kept saving in the first game? Rock, no. That wasn't Marissa. That was Alyssa. Oh, okay. I knew it ended with Sa, but I couldn't remember her full name. I'm really sorry you can handle this.
Hey, you can handle this. You're so much cooler than she is.
Just to you. Thanks, Max.
There's a song that's got that line in it. All right, we've looked at everything. Let's sit on the sofa.
You're such a space hog.
Oh, we might have been able to take a photo of Chloe there, Chloe then, but... it's all right. Oh, they look so happy. And is that a scratch pad?
I wish this moment could last for...
Rock, I should add a sound command of you saying pogger lull. You do the clip, Rock, and I'll add it. Since you redeemed it, you do the sound clip, I'll add it.
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
I don't even remember what I'm supposed to be doing in this. Oh, photo. Dink. Rock, you'll do that later. Sweet. Pose or photograph alone? Let's pose.
Take a break for a second.
This artist waits for
no stop.
I love how she always gets the photos perfect.
That was worth stop.
That was worth stopping for is what she was meant to have said. Rock, you'll try to do it as loud as possible. Just... Pogger! Yeah.
Peeking at my work?
I wasn't.
Get out of here!
Yes, ma'am. Ooh. We can take a photo of the hat now.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that?
Pogger, woo! Pogger, woo!
Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Oh, dear Lord, what?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
Exclamation cute. Pogger. Or exclamation pog.
There are no mistakes.
Because, you know, that'd be funny. All right, so let's see.
Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
Billy the Squid.
It's good to see you, old
friend. Old friend.
Try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house.
Alright, we got the panel.
Comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Maybe you should come down and power of flight this dude's face off with me. What? Oh my god. Invention plans.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Voice actor leveling up 2. You are now the Crossed level 105. Congrats, Crossed, on your leveling up. Even though you already have done 5 levels ago. But, you know, hey. And I can't get slapped for that. By the way, just saying. Can't do it. The chopper. Switches pedals from wheels to blades. Also spins blades. World's most comfortable seat. New slap. Because voice actor is now the Crossed. Flaming fingers, flint, steel. Oh dear. Yeah, that was totally intentional. Rock, yeah. Ray of sunshine. Sunlight enters here. Mirrors and lenses to strengthen sunlight. Opens intake window. Laser beam shoots out here. That's totally how light works, yes. Predictions.
Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
More fat foreshadowing, really? Predictions for the future by Chloe and Maxine. 1. We still hang out with each other, more than with any other person. 2. Both of us are medium popular. 3. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. 4. We do not make decisions without consulting each other. The talking skull of our enemies. 5. Both of us have a pet. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could have come if she wanted. 1 of us has a little sister or brother. We are doing well in school.
I'm a little bit hungry. How about you?
I'm okay.
Have we looked at everything? I think we might have. Let's just double check. Can I run? No, of course not. Yeah, we've looked at that bulletin board. We've looked at the photo. We've tidied up. We've looked at that photo. We looked at the capsule. We looked at the magazine. We've looked at everything there. Yep, we looked at that. We looked at that. Okay, let's talk to Chloe.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly.
Jeez, this jawbreaker is going to last forever. I love it.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh. Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else?
Oh.
I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
This is the day.
Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
Stellar. Yep, exactly, Rock. No questions. Yeah, just definitely try to tell her.
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
Rock, you're surprised it's not one of the ridiculously important decisions.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
Like the ones with the background sound that go
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
Why did you pretend I should have told you? Yeah, we'll go with I should have told you earlier.
I should have just told you earlier. I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning, but...
But I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us.
All day, she meant to say.
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so...
Rock, how did she react? She already knew.
Left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
Yep. Max's parents told Chloe's parents, and she overheard them talking about it. We'll keep in touch and visit. I'm worried I won't be okay. I think we'll go with D.
I'm so worried that I won't be okay without you.
Hey, stop that. Of course you'll be okay. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
for this son.
Rock, that was one of the memories that got changed. Not totally. I mean, it depends on what you decided to do with the memories, yeah. Oh, poor Chloe. Smilebringer, Twitch has to solve this issue with the games because you don't want to get banned for playing a game. Yeah, exactly. Rock, actually, Max still moved in the alternate reality. Yeah. That was one thing she couldn't change because it was her parents' choice, not hers. Tape said I'm sorry. Does she listen to it? She does.
My voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea.
So sad.
I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you.
It's sad from the pre.
We'll get good at it.
Prequel.
Write and talk all the time, and then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay?
Aww. So sad.
We're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
Oh, poor Chloe. And soon after this, she went into total punk phase. And never really left it. Aw, poor, poor Chloe. Right, that's the end of the pre-episode, or the bonus episode.